Welcome everyone, welcome in class 10 chapter 6 triangles. Today we will know and understand everything about triangles. I am drawing a triangle here. A triangle is a polygon of three sides. This is the vertex A, vertex B and vertex C. A triangle is a polygon of three sides. A triangle has total six parts, and this we have already learned in standard 7th. This is angle A, this is angle B and this is angle C. So the three angles, angle A, angle B and angle C are the parts of the triangle. This side AB, this side BC and this side AC are the three sides of the triangle. AB, this is the side BC and the third side AC. A triangle has three angles and three sides and together they are called parts of a triangle. Let's understand what are similar triangles. Two triangles or polygons are said to be similar to each other if their corresponding angles are equal and the lengths of their corresponding sides are proportional. Now I am drawing two similar triangles. In similar triangles, the shape is same, but the size is not necessarily the same. This is a triangle ABC and this is the triangle DEF. We can say that the triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF if angle A is equal to angle D, angle B equals to angle E, and angle C, this one, is equal to angle F. Here all the three angles are equal and they have one-to-one correspondence. And the ratio of AB upon DE is equal to the ratio of BC upon EF is equal to AC upon DF. So two triangles are similar if their corresponding angles are equal and the length of their corresponding sides are proportional. Then we can say triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. To write equal corresponding angle of two similar triangles in appropriate order is very, very important. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF. It shows that angle A equals to angle D, angle B equals to angle E, this angle B is equal to angle E, and this angle C is equal to angle F. Also, the ratio of AB upon DE is equal to BC upon EF is equal to AC upon DF. Next we have basic proportionality theorem, or this is also known as Thales theorem. Let's see what is the Thales theorem. If a line is drawn parallel to one side of a triangle to intersect the other two sides at two distinct points, then it divides the other two sides in the same ratio. Let's draw a triangle. Let's name the vertices A, B and C. Let's draw a line parallel to BC. This line is intersecting AB at D and AC at E. So in a triangle ABC, if DE, this DE is parallel to BC, then the ratio of AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC. This is the basic proportionality theorem. We call it in short BPT. Let's understand the converse of basic proportionality theorem. If a line divides any two sides of a triangle in the same ratio, then the line is parallel to the third side. Let's draw triangle ABC. We'll draw a line DE which is intersecting AB at point D and AC at point E. If in a triangle ABC, AD upon DB is equal to AE upon EC, then DE must be parallel to BC. There is some criteria for similarity of triangles, as we have learned criteria for congruency of triangles in standard 7. The first criteria, AAA similarity criteria, if in two triangles corresponding angles are equal, then their corresponding sides are in the same ratio and hence the two triangles are similar. Here we have triangle ABC and triangle PQR. If angle A is equal to the corresponding angle P, if angle B is equal to the corresponding angle Q, and if angle C is equal to corresponding angle R, then triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, and the ratio of the corresponding sides of both the similar triangles are also equal. Means we can write AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR is equal to AC upon PR. Next is AA similarity criteria. If two angles of one triangle are respectively equal to the two angles of another triangle, then the two triangles are similar. This is triangle ABC and this is triangle PQR. We are given angle A is equal to angle P and angle B is equal to angle Q. In both the triangles, if two corresponding angles are equal, then what about the third angle? Let's find the third angle of both the triangles by using angle sum property of a triangle. We know that by angle sum property, the third angle C of triangle ABC we can get by adding angle A and angle B and then subtracting it from 180 degree. But we also know that angle A is equal to angle P and angle B is equal to angle Q. We get 180 degree minus angle P plus angle Q equals to, after subtracting the sum of angle P and angle Q from 180 degree, we'll get angle R. It shows that if two corresponding angles of one triangle are equal to the two corresponding angle of another triangle, then their third corresponding angles will also be equal. So here again, we have all the three corresponding angles are equal. So we can write triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. We can also write the ratio of the corresponding sides of the triangles are also equal. Hence, AB ratio PQ is equal to BC ratio QR is equal to AC ratio PR. This is the AA similarity. Next is SSS similarity criteria. If in two triangles corresponding sides are in the same ratio, then their corresponding angles are equal and hence the triangles are similar. Let's see two triangles ABC and triangle PQR. Here we are given the ratio of the corresponding sides are equal. So we are given the ratio of side AB and PQ is equal to the ratio of the side BC and QR is equal to side AC upon PR. Here, the ratio of the corresponding sides of both the triangles are equal, then the triangles are similar, and since the triangles are similar, we can write angle A equals to angle P, angle B equals to angle Q, and angle C equals to angle R. And here again, the triangles are similar. Triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Next is SAS similarity criteria. If in two triangles, one angle of a triangle is equal to the one angle of another triangle and the sides including these angles are in the same ratio, then the triangles are similar. This is triangle ABC, this is triangle PQR. Here we are given one angle in triangle ABC is equal to one angle of triangle PQR, means angle A equals to angle P, and the sides including this angle means side AB and AC. And for angle P, sides forming angle P are PQ and PR. So in two triangles ABC and PQR, if angle A is equal to angle P and the ratio of AB and AC is equal to the ratio of PQ and PR, then we can say triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR. Next, we have one more important result of similar triangles. Let's see, there are two similar triangles ABC and triangle DEF. If the triangle ABC is similar to triangle DEF, then the ratio of area of triangle ABC and area of triangle DEF is equal to the ratio of the squares of their corresponding sides, means AB square upon DE square equals to BC square upon EF square equals to AC square upon DF square. The result is the ratio of the areas of two similar triangles is equal to the square of the ratio of their corresponding sides. We have one more important result of similar triangles. If triangle ABC is similar to triangle PQR, we know that the ratio of the corresponding sides will be equal, means AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR is equal to AC upon PR. This ratio is also equal to the ratio of the perimeters of both the triangles, means perimeter of triangle ABC upon perimeter of triangle PQR. If we draw medians from the vertex A and from the vertex P, in triangle ABC, AM is the median, and in triangle PQR, PN is the median, then this ratio is also equal to the ratio of the corresponding medians. Next result is a Pythagoras theorem. Pythagoras theorem says in a right triangle, the square of the hypotenuse, which is the longest side of the triangle, is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. Here we have a right triangle, triangle ABC. AC is the longest side, hypotenuse. AB is the perpendicular and BC is the base. And angle B is a right angle. Here the triangle is right angled at B. So the opposite side of the right angle, which is AC, the square of AC is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides. Or we can say AC's hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. Let's see converse of Pythagoras theorem. In a triangle, if the square of one side is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides, then the angle opposite to the side is the right angle. Here I have a triangle. This is triangle A, B, C. The length of side AC is 5 cm. The length of side AB is 3 cm. And the length of side BC is 4 cm. If the square of the longest side, which is AC here, is equal to the sum of the squares of the other two sides, they are AB square plus BC square. We'll put the value. AC is the longest side 5 square, AB 3 square plus BC is 4 square. We'll get 25 equals to 9 plus 16. On both the sides, we get 25 equals to 25. So we can say triangle ABC is a right angled triangle and the angle opposite to the longest side is angle B, which is a right angle. Angle B is a right angle. Here, angle opposite to the longest side AC is angle B. Therefore, angle B equals to 90 degrees. Last but not the least, again one more important result. If a perpendicular is drawn from the vertex of a right angle of a right triangle to the hypotenuse, then the triangle on both sides of the perpendicular are similar to the whole triangle and also similar to each other. Here I am drawing a right triangle. This is a right triangle A, B, C, right angled at B. If we draw a perpendicular from the vertex B on AC, it meets AC at point D. Here we have total three triangles, two small triangles inside the big triangle. And these three triangles are similar to each other. Triangle ABD is similar to triangle ABC. Triangle CBD is similar to triangle CBA. And triangle ABD is similar to triangle BCD. Here both the smaller triangles are similar to each other. And they are also similar to the bigger triangle. Let's check that the small triangle ABD is similar to the bigger triangle ABC. And for this, we'll use similarity criteria of triangles. Now we'll write the correct names of the similar triangles. First of all, we'll write triangle ABD similar to triangle ACB. Why this order? Let's see. Here, the first angle A is common in both the triangles. Angle D is also common, each 90 degrees. We can write angle A common in both the triangles and angle D and angle B, they both are 90 degrees. And by AA similarity, both the triangles are similar. And if the triangles are similar, we can say that angle ABD, this angle of the small triangle is equal to angle ACB. Second, triangle BDC is similar to triangle ABC. Why I have written this order? In small triangle, angle D is 90 degrees. And in the big triangle, angle B is 90 degrees. So, B vertex will be in the middle for the big triangle. Also, in this triangle, angle C is common. This is angle in this triangle. Angle C is common. Angle C is common for the big triangle and this orange triangle. So, at third place, we'll write C. In the middle, we'll write B. Now, which angle is left in the big triangle? Yes, that is angle A. In the small triangle, angle D is in the middle, which is 90 degrees. And in big triangle, angle B is 90 degrees. In small triangle and in big triangle, angle C is common. So by AA similarity, triangle BDC is similar to triangle ABC. In this small orange triangle, this angle B will be equal to this angle A of the big triangle. I have made them equal by putting three lines. Now we can easily prove the similarity between the two triangles which are inside the big triangle. Triangle ABD, which is the small triangle with green color, is similar to the triangle which is orange. To write the appropriate order of similarity, we can see angle A of green triangle is equal to angle B of orange triangle. Angle B of green triangle is equal to angle C of orange angle. And at point D, in both the triangles, there is 90 degree angle. Let's check the order once again. Angle A is equal to angle B. This angle A is equal to angle B. Now, angle B is equal to angle C. I have put double line to show these angles equal. And angle D is equal to angle D, 90 degree each. Now we'll correct the order which we had written earlier. Triangle ABD is similar to triangle ACB. You can see it is triangle ACB. Triangle CBD is similar to triangle. Here the order is different. CBD. Okay. CBD. So it will be CAB. Triangle CAB. And third, triangle ABD is similar to triangle BCD. So it is correct. By AA similarity criteria, we can prove similarity of these triangles. That's all we had in this chapter, triangles. Now you practice, make notes and be ready for exam. Thank you for watching and learning. Please do like, share and subscribe the channel. Stay healthy and stay safe.